Hi there, welcome to my channel Code Canvas. In this video, I will explain how you can show and hide div on the click of radio button using JavaScript and jQuery. So first of all, let's create some HTML. Let's add one form with some action. Doesn't matter for now. Let's say we have one checkbox or radio button. Type is equal to radio, name is equal to language, and ID is equal to PHP, and value is also equal to PHP. So here we are asking user to select his favorite language, and let's add label with for attribute. Let's see how it looks. Let's add one br to make it more readable and copy and paste labels 3 times. Here you can add a language Java, for example. And the third value is Python. So here we will ask user to select his favorite language. It is PHP, Java, or Python. That's fine. And we will add another div for content. Let's copy and paste some content from Wikipedia. This is for PHP. Second div is for Java. And third one is for Python. So what we are achieving here, when you click on PHP, it will show a div, the content for PHP, and it will hide rest of the divs. Same as for Java and Python. So for that we need to add ID or class. Let's say content underscore PHP is the ID value for PHP paragraph. Here you can add ID is equal to content underscore Java, for example. And for the last div, you can add content underscore Python. That's all from HTML. You need to create one function here. Show hide content, the function name, and let's write down that function. We need to call this function. So calling it, let's see if it is working. Yeah, JavaScript is working fine. So here you need to click radio button. For that you need to add document dot query selector. You can use document dot get element ID as well, but I prefer to use query selector. ID is PHP, so you need to add ID hash PHP dot add event listener and click event is the event name. In the function, you have to, when click on this, you have to hide these two paragraphs. So for that you need to write down document dot query selector of ID. The ID is content underscore PHP dot display dot style dot display is equal to block, and you need to hide other two divs. So you need to change the ID content underscore Python and content underscore Java, and you need to change tile dot display is equal to none. So let's see. When you click, let's inspect the element. You should see content_php display block is there, and content_java and content_python is display none. So it's working fine. Just like this, you can listen elements, the click events for Java and Python as well. When you click on Java, content_java should be display block and other two display none, and same for Python display none and display block. Let's see how it works. So on load, it is showing all three divs, because on load we haven't written any code, so it is showing all three divs. But when you click on PHP, it will hide other two divs and show the content for PHP. When you click on Java, it will hide PHP and Python content, and when you click on Python, it will hide PHP and Java content. So it's working fine. If you want to make more changes on page load, you can hide a Java and Python div. So for that, you just need to copy here content_php is equal to already, it is already display block, so you don't need to change anything. Here you need to add display none for Java and display none for content_. So on page load, you can see only PHP content is showing there, right? If you also want to tag this PHP, then in HTML you need to add checked as well. So when the page loads, you can see the PHP is checked by default, and when you click on Java, it will hide PHP and Python, and same for Python. So it's working fine. When you reload, it's working fine when you click. So this is the approach using plain JavaScript. If you want to use jQuery, I can show that method as well. For that, let's add jQuery CDN, the jQuery library link. Let me just copy this script tag and paste it here. It is already there. Yeah, it is already there. Let me just paste. So in JavaScript, let me just rename the function name, and let me copy this function and change the name of the function. Here document.querySelector will be jQuery, because jQuery is an object provided by jQuery library. It's done. Also, you need to write down style.display. Instead of style.display, you can call a function hide and same for other divs. For display block, you can write down function show, a jQuery function. Right here also we need to change hide. Let's add that function here, hide. Yeah, that's all. And here, instead of add event listener, you can use jQuery element dot on and click event. See, so let's make sure that this function is getting called. Yeah, this is function that we are calling. So on load, it is working fine. When you check, when you change, it is working as expected. We can also write down some animations, like when you hide that, you can hide it fast and fast, and when you show, when you click on the radio button, you can also make it some fast and slow as animate. Let's see how it works. As you can see, some effects are there, right? So using both methods, using pure JavaScript as well as using jQuery, you can always hide and show divs. I'm sure that there are multiple ways you can achieve this, but this is the easiest way I can think of. Please leave your comments if you have any other ideas in your mind. Please subscribe my channel for more related videos, including CSS, JavaScript, and PHP. That's all for this video. Hope to see you soon. Thank you.